Hey everybody, Mr. Macintosh here. So you just finished installing macOS Big Sur or macOS Monterey on your unsupported Mac with OpenCore Legacy Patcher. But now you want to be able to install Windows 10 so you can dual boot either operating systems on the same Mac. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the UEFI version of Windows 10 using a USB flash drive. We got a lot to cover. Let's jump in and get started. Okay, before we begin, let's go over some really quick points so you understand what's going to happen in this video, so you understand the format. I'm going to cut it up into chapters so you can go to each section that you need to go. But this is a really important part we'll go over really quick here before we begin. First of all, this video is for installing Windows 10 in UEFI mode so you can dual boot your unsupported Mac with OpenCore Legacy Patcher running Big Sur or macOS Monterey. If you're not running OpenCore Legacy Patcher on your older Mac, I might make a video that just shows you how to install Bootcamp the standard way. Let me know in the comments if that's something that you're looking for. Now the next thing is when installing Windows 10 plus OpenCore Legacy Patcher, we have two different ways to install. Like I mentioned above, this video is going to be for UEFI and GPT file system. In my next video, I'm going to show you how to install Windows 10 with Legacy BIOS or Master Boot Record or MBR file system. A Legacy Master Boot Record install can have better reliability and have less driver issues for 2013 and older Macs. And the next thing we got to talk about is backup all your data. This is important and I recommend this even before installing software updates for macOS. Everything's going to go fine and I've installed this so many times without a single problem, but in case of disaster, you have your files just in case. The next thing is, you don't need another Mac to do this exercise. A lot of the other videos that I watched shows that you needed a Windows PC to do all this different thing, like create a boot disk or download the Windows 10. You don't need this. All you need is the Mac that you're going to be working on for this video. And then the final part here is the update section. In my other videos, like the OpenCore Legacy Patcher with Monterey, I put an update section in the description of the video in case there's any new information that you might need to know about in the future if this video changes or something changes in the way that we install. So take a look at that before you do that if you're watching this video in the future. And the next thing is equipment needed. All you need is your Mac and a USB flash drive, 16 gigabytes or larger. Now let's quickly talk about the compatibility for Windows 10 UEFI. Now, if you look at this chart here, Windows and Bootcamp app compatibility by year. From 2011 to 2012, you have basic UEFI compatibility. The install does work, but you might have some issues like some blue screen of deaths or driver issues that you might have to work through if you install on these older units. If you look at some of the documentation, it says that only 2012 has UEFI compatibility, but the OpenCore Legacy Patcher guide does mention that 2011 does work for UEFI installs. Now the next part is 2013 to 2014 models that support both EFI and Legacy BIOS. Mid-2013 MacBook Pro and Macs Bootcamp installs Legacy BIOS by default. Late 2013 and 2014 installs EFI by default in Bootcamp. In 2015 and later, install support EFI mode only by default and is fully UEFI compliant. The next, I've got a couple links here. I've got the link to the instructions for UEFI Windows install through the OpenCore Legacy Patcher page. I also have a really nice Bootcamp chart that shows you all the different drivers that you need. I'm also going to include a Windows 10 ISO link here, and I'm going to put all these links in the description below. The other thing is I wanted to give a big thanks. I had to do a phone a friend for this because this is a very confusing situation, and that's why there's not that many websites or videos talking about this particular setup installing Windows 10 with OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Vinay, you were a super help and you basically gave me an entire masterclass in how UEFI and Legacy Boot work with the Mac and Windows 10 installs. And I also wanted to thank Martin Noble, and you got to check out his channel. He has a wonderful channel on all things Mac and Windows. He helped out with a lot of other questions too. And real quick before we begin, I wanted to talk about Windows 11. Windows 11 is compatible with these Macs here, but I wanted to keep that as a separate video and let me know in the comments if that's something that you want to install. I am doing Windows 10 here because we don't have to hack the installation for the TPM chip or anything like that. It's just a straightforward install with Windows 10. It's fully compatible. That's why we're doing this exercise with Windows 10. So let's get started. Okay, we're ready to get started on our OpenCore Legacy Mac running macOS Monterey. So let's take a quick look at Disk Utility and see the partition layout here. Open up Disk Utility and then go up to View and then click Show All Devices. As you can see, we are just running macOS Monterey here in a single container when we look at the partition. We are going to partition this in half, so half is going to be Windows and half is going to be macOS Monterey. And again, this works with macOS Big Sur. It does not matter. Now that we understand that, let's minimize that. We have to download the Windows 10 ISO. So all we need to do is open up Safari or use the link in the description. And it's going to be the first link here. Download Windows 10 disk image. Make sure it's from Microsoft.com. Click on this. And then we'll scroll down here. And then we're going to select the edition that we want to be able to download. There's only one. And it is Windows 10. Click on confirm. Start the next page. And it's going to say, which product do you need? Click on the choose one. And then you want to choose your language. Once language is selected, click confirm. It's going to ask you whether you want to download the 64-bit or the 32-bit. Make sure you always download the 64-bit. And click allow. It's going to immediately start to download into your downloads folder here. Okay, the download is complete. It might take a little while. The full install ISO is 5.8 gigabytes, so it'll take a little bit of time to download, but once it's here, there it is in our downloads folder. Now we're ready to go to the next step. We can open up the Bootcamp Assistant app in the utilities folder in applications. You'll see that this is the beginning of the Bootcamp Assistant. We'll click on continue here. Now what we're going to be greeted with is three separate options. Create Windows 10 install disk, download the latest support drivers for this particular model, and also install Windows 10 or later. We want all these selected, so click on continue. This is the part where we have to install the USB drive. So plug in your USB drive now, and we'll open up Disk Utility so we can see when that loads, and there it is. Now, you should not have to format the drive. Most USB drives from the store are formatted in Master Boot Record, so if you wanted to, you can just click on Erase. The formatting really doesn't matter, but again, before we erase, make sure that you have all the files off this USB before we erase, just in case you have something on there. Now, the format doesn't matter. You can format in XFAT and Master Boot Record, it doesn't really matter because the Bootcamp Assistant will format the drive properly. So just click erase and that's done. Now we can minimize Disk Utility and go back here. Now we can click on continue. And it's going to say a couple things here. It's going to say, well, where's your ISO? The best part is that the Bootcamp Assistant already has selected it in the downloads folder. It's found the ISO and it's already selected it. And it's saying, where's the destination disk that you want to create the USB installer? We're creating it on the USB drive that we just plugged in. And it does give you one final warning that the drive will be formatted. So let's click on continue. And there we go. It's going to format the drive and it's going to download the software. Put the software on there, use the ISO to create the bootable Windows 10 installer for us. And this is going to take a little while, depending on your internet connection, because the drivers are going to be anywhere between 2 and 600 megabytes for the full Bootcamp Assistant drivers. And then it's going to take time to copy that full installer over to the USB drive. So we'll give this some time and we'll pick up right when it's all done. Okay, it just finished. So now we're at create a partition for Windows. Each operating system requires its own partition on the disk. Drag this slider to set the size of the partition. Your Mac will reboot automatically after the operation completes. Now, keep in mind, it's really difficult to resize the partition for Bootcamp once it's created. So let's think about how much space you have on the Mac first, how much space you'll need, and think about how much space you're gonna need in the Windows. Are you just using it for light tasks? Then you can keep it pretty small. But if you're gonna be installing games on there, for example, you might want to set it a little bit bigger. For example, this Mac Mini has a 1 terabyte drive, so I don't really have to worry about it. Or if you have, for example, a 128 gigabyte flash drive or a 256, you might have to be a little careful with setting this up. So set this up, you can drag this slider, you click in here, you drag this to what you want, and then click on install. The next thing it's going to do is it's actually going to partition the disk, so it splits it up into these equal parts. This part will take either anywhere between 1 and 3 minutes. We'll be right back when it's done. Okay, before this finishes here, I wanted to go over two really tricky items here. And the first thing is that it mentioned that it's going to reboot after automatically into the installer. Now, if you have a late 2013 or 2014, 15 or newer Mac, this is fine because it's gonna automatically format the drive in GPT file system and then boot the EFI installer right into the Windows installer. Now, if you have a mid-2013 or lower around this time, it's going to format the drive in master boot record, and that is not going to be compatible with the UEFI install boot that we're going to use when booting up into the Windows installer. So what we need to do is that if you have a newer Mac, we can just let this thing boot right into the installer, but we're going to have to hold on the option and wait for the boot picker, and I'm going to show you how to do that. If you have an older Mac, we have to format the drive before it restarts. So if this thing restarts and you have a mid-2013 or lower, we're going to have to reformat the drive back in Mac OS, and then once we boot into the Windows installer, we'll be able to format the drive properly. We'll be able to install UEFI install on a GPT disk. Okay, so I'm going to split this up into two sections. This first section is going to be 2014 or 2015. We're going to reboot right to the installer so it can show you the installation process. Now, if you have an older one, just skip to the next section where I show you what to do and how to format the disk before you reboot back into the installer. So let's get started now. So all we need to do, the installer automatically reboots when this part is done at the very end. When this finishes, the Mac automatically restarts. But what we need to do is hold on the option to get to the boot picker here. So let's do that now. We're going to manually start because I already had it restart so I can show you this example. So let's just say this got all the way to the end and automatically restarts. So we're going to do is hold on the option key so we get the boot picker selection menu when the Mac restarts and first boots. You hear the chime? Give it a second here. All right, there we go. So now, as you can see, we have our Windows partition. That's not going to do anything because it's empty. We have our EFI boot. That's the USB installer for Windows. We have our Macintosh hard drive that has macOS Monterey on it. And we have our OpenCore Legacy Patcher EFI boot. So continue holding down Option and hit Enter on the EFI boot of OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Then wait. And then it's going to show Macintosh hard drive so we can boot back into macOS Monterey. And then right over to the Windows and then hit Enter. Now what it's going to do is it's going to boot into the Windows 10 installer with UEFI or EFI mode to install. So we'll give it a second here, and before you know it, we'll be in the installer. Okay, or the setup is starting. Now the way to tell if you're in EFI install mode is that the window will be more square. If it's a bigger rectangle, you can tell that you're in master boot record type install. So the next thing we're going to do is click on next. And then if you have your Windows 10 product key, put it in here. Now for the example here, I'm just going to click do not have a product key, and I'm going to click on Windows 10 Pro and then next, and then accept the license terms. Now we're at the partition screen, and this is where we could have problems, right? If you see this next button and it's ready to be clickable, you're ready to go. And that's why it's really easy. 2014, again, depending on your Mac, if you have a 2013 machine and this is not clickable, then you're going to have to skip to the next section. I'll show you what to do. But as long as you have, again, a 2014 and newer, you can click on this next and it'll immediately start to install. So I'm going to click this now and we'll get started. And then we're going to go into the next section if you have a 2013 or older Mac and what we need to do. Okay, this section is for if you have a 2013 to 2011 older Mac, that Bootcamp Assistant formatted the disk in master boot record, and that's not going to be compatible with the EFI installer. So all we need to do is go into Disk Utility, and then we're going to click on the Bootcamp partition once it loads here, and then we're going to format it. So we're going to click on it here, and again, I have View Show All Devices here, so you can see all the partitions. We'll click on Bootcamp, and all we need to do is click on Erase, and then we're going to change the format to XFAT, and then hit Erase. That's it. Click on Done, and close Disk Utility. And we're going to reboot to the Windows 10 installer. So click on restart and make sure you hold down the option key. And I've got it clicked on and held down right now. Got the chime. Continue holding on to option. Okay, there we go. What we'll do is we're going to click on EFI boot, continue holding down option, and then hit enter or click on the arrow for EFI boot open core. And then as soon as you get to the next screen, hit the right arrow into Windows and hit Enter. Now we're going to boot into the EFI installer. Okay, this app is starting. Okay, we'll click on Next. And then if you have your product key, you can type it in here. I'm going to click on Do Not, since we're doing our this as a demonstration. Click on Windows 10 Pro or whatever version you have. Click on I accept the terms, hit next. Now this is where we're gonna have to format the drive inside Windows Setup. So if you click on this, notice how it's grayed out. All we need to do here is click on Format and then click OK. And there we go. Now the button is selectable. Again, if for some reason you get an error here, it's talking about GPT file partitioning, or you have any other type of error, usually it's because of the formatting or the version of Windows that you're trying to boot into. Like if you're trying to boot up the master boot record, and then click on Next. And there we go, we're starting. So we'll let this go and install. And when we come back, we'll walk through the Windows 10 Setup Assistant and we'll install the drivers for Ethernet, sound, graphics, and all that through the USB Bootcamp Assistant installer. So we'll see you in a little bit. And do is you let it restart to the installer, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna hold down the Option key so we make sure that we boot into the installer. Okay, click on the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. And then click on Windows and hit Enter. And then it's going to continue the installation. Hey, we're at the Setup Assistant screen of Windows 10. All we need to do is walk through this setup. And before you know it, we'll be on the desktop and I'll walk you through how to install the drivers. Okay, we're in Windows 10. Now, the best thing is that when we use the Bootcamp and install the drivers to the USB disk, they automatically start the Bootcamp installer as soon as you get into Windows. Now, if you see this matches for Edge, you can just click on Maybe Later. Then we can go right to the Bootcamp Assistant to install all of the Windows 10 drivers for the Mac that you have. So all I need to do is click on Next and accept the terms in the license agreement and click on Install. It's going to take a little while to install from the USB flash drive to the internal hard drive of the Windows 10 installation. And it might flash the screen because it's installing the graphics packages and stuff like that. And before you know it, it'll be done at the end of the installation. And we'll cut to that when it gets there. Okay, we finished. The Bootcamp installer has completed. Bootcamp has successfully installed on your computer. Click Finish to exit the installer. So we'll do that now. And then it's going to say, hey, we need to reboot for all the drivers to put into play. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to hold down that option again. But I'm going to show you how to make the Windows version of the partition set up in the boot picker default. Now you can do this because since we're dual booting now, we're always going to use the OpenCore Legacy Patcher EFI selection first. Then we will pick either Monterey or Big Sur or Windows 10 or Windows 11, for example. So we'll hold down Option, and as soon as the boot picker comes up, we're going to select OpenCore Legacy Patcher EFI boot. There's our chime. Give it a second here. So now what we do is we can hold down Control and it turns into, see how it's turning into a circle with an arrow, and we can click on Enter to make that default. And as soon as we get in, then we can do that again, and then we can make Windows default. So we don't have to hold down the Option key anymore. Anytime we start this system now, it'll automatically boot into Windows 10. If you want it to boot into macOS Monterey or Big Sur, all you do is hold down Option again. Keep holding down Option after you click on the OpenCore Legacy Patcher boot EFI, and then hold down Control to select Monterey if you want that to be the default operating system to boot into every time. But if you want to just go into one, just one time, all you need to do is click it without holding down Control, and you're back into the operating system. Okay, we're at the login window. We'll click on it once, and we'll be able to log in here. Okay, we're back at the desktop here. We'll give this a second for this WinSat.exe to finish here, and it'll disappear. And then the taskbar here down below will finish loading, and we'll be able to connect to Wi-Fi. And then we'll be able to check sound, graphics, and make sure that we start the Windows update system. because sometimes Windows Update has drivers updates for different parts, and we can also check the Apple software update, and I'll show you how to do that in a second. So first, to connect to Wi-Fi, all we need to do is click on this world down here, and we'll connect to our Wi-Fi. Okay, as you can see down here, we are connected to our Wi-Fi. Now, the first thing we can do is we can check for sound. So we can just click on the sound icon down here, and what we can do is we can click on here, and you should hear sound coming out. Now, since I have a HDMI monitor connected here, I'm going to have to go into the sound settings and check the and change the output, and you might have to do this too. Go into the sound settings, and then here's the output. So what we want to do is we want to click on the speakers. Click on the speakers, and we can should be able to click the volume here. And there you go. You hear that sound? So we've got sound. Now the next thing we can do is we can look at the device manager, and we can check to make sure that the driver is installed properly. And it looks like everything is installed good. If you had a problem with one of the drivers, you would see one of these opened up with, like this. You would see it like this, and there would be a little circle with a exclamation point. So it looks like everything is installed properly. So that's really good. We can also check in the system information app to see what type of installer mode. And as you can see here, BIOS mode UEFI. So that confirms that that's the proper way that we installed Windows. So we can close on this. The next thing we wanna do is check Apple software update. And there we got three. Now, sometimes there's problems with installing other ones if there's a boot camp update. So sometimes you might have to install this one first, then you can install these other ones. But a lot of times you can just attempt to install all three and they'll all three install. Now, after that's done, you can go over and install Windows Update. And now keep in mind, Windows updates, the way they go is they automatically start to install and download. So you can see they're automatically downloading and installing in the background here. And you can kind of scroll down and see what's going on. When they're finished, they're going to reboot the system, and then you're going to be fully up to date with Windows 10. And that's dual booting Windows 10 UEFI in macOS Monterey or macOS Big Sur with OpenCore Legacy Patcher. I hope you're able to install Windows 10 properly. And if you have any questions, be sure to post them in the comments section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up or a share. I would really appreciate it. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, you can click on that subscribe button. Or if you're already a subscriber or viewer, I truly appreciate it. If you want to see more macOS Monterey videos, click on the playlist in this window. Also, you can visit MrMacIntosh.com, where I post all my blog articles. You can also follow me on Twitter at Classic2_MrMac. And if you want to be a supporter of the channel, you can join my brand new Patreon. And I have already a very generous group of patrons. I truly appreciate it. Appreciate you guys, and we'll catch you in the next video. Thanks.